That's me, Fred the House Cat. When my family leaves for the day, I don't just sit inside watching the world go by. I become... Nature Cat! Backyard Explorer Extraordinaire!
Gals, what's with all the music?
Today, in our own backyard, we are holding the first annual Woodstock Jellapalooza!
Woodstock Jellapalooza? Man, oh man, I love Woodstock Jellapalooza! But one teeny tiny question, what's Woodstock Jellapalooza?
Hey, that's usually my line, I think, right? Isn't that right, baby?
Sorry, Hal. It just makes more sense for me to say it this episode. Cool?
Woodstock Jellapalooza is a music festival, Daisy.
But not just any music festival. No, 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 no. It's a music festival that honors nature.
Ooh, I love music and I love nature. That's win-win for me, baby.
Hey, I thought I always said that, too.
You do, too, also.
Oh, okay.
So, what kind of nature songs are we going to sing?
Our own songs, Daisy.
Yeah, man, that's the best part of Woodstock Jellapalooza. We make up the songs ourselves.
Gosh, I've never made up my own song before. I'm not sure I can do it.
Of course you can, Daisy. It's all part of Woodstock Jellapalooza.
Hey!
Grab your guitar.
A piano, too.
Clap your hands. Stomp your shoe.
Make up a song and you just can't lose at Woodstock Jellapalooza.
Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza. Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza.
Sing about nature, sing about the sky.
Sing about the trees or the mountain high.
You'll be inspired when you see the views at Woodstock Jellapalooza.
Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza. Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza.
Sing about animals.
Sing about plants.
Sing about elephants.
Sing about
sing about whatever you choose at Woodstock Jellapalooza.
Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza. Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza. Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza. Woodstock, hey! Jellapalooza.
Woodstock, Jellapalooza! Yeah!
Wow! It blows my mind. You just made up that song! Oh, you guys, I've never made up a song before.
Anyone can do it, just, I don't know, take a tune from another song and, like, I don't know, put your own nature words to it, I guess.
You can do that?
Check it out.
Nature Cat, he had a yard, Y-A-R-D yard, and in that yard he had some...
pine cones?
Y-A-R-D yard, with a pine cone here and a pine cone there. Pine cone, everywhere pine cone. Nature Cat, he had a yard, Y-A-R-D yard, Y-A-R-D yard.
Wow!
Now it's your turn, Daisy. Please give a warm Woodstock Jellapalooza welcome to Daisy!
Woo-hoo! Oh, I'm terrible at this. I just can't make up a song about nature.
I believe you can, Daisy. You just need a little inspiration.
Onward and Songward!
Oh, I hear something. It sounds like a birdie tweet.
But how would you make a song out of it?
Like this, perhaps. Here I am. I'm on the trail. I'm hiking with my feet. I hear the sound when the birdies call. They go tweet, tweet, tweet. Tweet, 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 tweet.
Whoa, tweet, 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 as I'm hiking to the mountain.
Whoa, tweet, 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 tweet.
Hey!
Tweet, 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 tweet.
That's right!
That is one sweet song!
Thanks, but we're not finished yet. Let's hike and listen to more sounds.
Hey, listen, sounds like the brook.
Yes, it does, and it's perfect for my song. We're walking here by the brook. I hear a sound, but it's not verbal. It's the sound the water makes. It goes burble, burble. Burble, 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 burble. The second sound I'm counting. Whoa, burble, 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 burble. As I'm hiking to the mountain. Just listen carefully for the sounds of nature. I hear something.
Oh, I hear it too.
See that squirrel with some acorns now. Look how his eyes twinkle. Hear the sound the acorns make. When they fall, they skinkle.
Skinkle?
That's what it sounds like to me. Skinkle, 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 skinkle. That's the next sound I'm counting. Whoa, skinkle, 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 as I'm hiking to the mountain. Sing with me!
Whoa, skinkle, 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 skinkle. Hey! Skinkle, 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 skinkle. Hey! Tweet, tweet, burble, skinkle, skinkle. Hey! Tweet, tweet, burble, skinkle, skinkle.
That's the sounds we heard today. The sounds that we were counting. All the sounds in nature. While we're hiking to the mountain.
While we're hiking to the mountains.
Hey!
While we're hiking to the mountains.
Hey!
While we're hiking to the mountains.
Hey!
While we're hiking to the mountains.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Woodstock Cellapalooza's newest songwriting sensation, Daisy!
I hear... Oh, that! I heard that! What was that?
That was the sound of the audience leaving, Daisy. I'm sorry.
Aw, that's a real bummer. Now I'll never be able to make up my own song.
Follow me.
Are you listening for sounds in my garden to make up your song?
Not exactly. I like to make up my songs in a different way.
But how?
I like to tell a story about the things I see in nature.
Ooh! What kind of story, Squeaks?
This kind of story. Goes a little something like this. 2, 3, 4. There were 3 little bees in the garden, hey, hey, and they were feeling mighty keen. Oh, 3 little bees in the garden, hey, hey, then one left to see the queen. Yeah, they buzzed and buzzed. Why? Because something was brand new. They buzzed and buzzed. Why? Because now there were only 2. Yes! There were 2 little bees in the garden, hey, hey, feeling so alive. 2 little bees in the garden, hey, hey, then one flew back to the hive. They buzzed and buzzed. Why? Because something had been done. They buzzed and buzzed. Why? Because now there was only 1. There was 1 little bee in the garden, hey, hey, felt like she had to fly. 1 little bee in the garden, hey, hey, it was time to say goodbye. No one buzzed and buzzed. Why? Because nothing left but flowers and trees. No one buzzed and buzzed. Why? Because there were 0 bees. No little bees in the garden, hey, hey, no insects all yellow and black. No little bees in the garden, hey, hey, but then all 3 flew back. The end.
Man, oh man, you just made up a story about nature in a song. I need to do that.
Then let's get to it. Put your wings together for Daisy with a story song.
A story, okay. But what can my story be about? I got nothing. I guess I can't be part of Woodstock Cellapalooza.
Come on, Daisy. We really want you to be a part of Woodstock Cellapalooza.
But Woodstock Cellapalooza is all about making up songs, and I just can't do it.
Wait a minute. I have an idea. Can you write a poem for Woodstock Cellapalooza?
A poem? Sure. That I can do. I love rhyming. I love the dirt and the rocks and the grass
and the trees. Love the birds and the squirrels and the worms and the bees. I love nature as much as Squeaks loves cheese. Cheese. Yes, I love nature.
That will make a terrific song.
But it's not a song, Nature Cat. It's a poem.
Yes, but it could be lyrics to a song.
It could?
Yeah, lyrics can rhyme just like your poem.
You're a librettist, my dear. Face it.
We just need to add some music, and your little poem will be transformed into a fabulous song.
Ooh, how?
Watch and be amazed.
I love the dirt and the rocks and the grass and the trees.
Wow!
Love the birds and the squirrels and the worms and the bees.
That sounds so good!
I love nature as much as Squeaks loves cheese.
Yes, I love nature.
Whoa, is that a song? Did I really help write a song?
Yeah!
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's sing my song!
1, 2, 3.
I love the dirt and the rocks and the grass and the trees. Love the birds and the squirrels and the worms and the bees. I love nature as much as Squeaks loves cheese. Yes, I love nature, everybody.
I love the dirt and the rocks and the grass and the trees. Love the birds and the squirrels and the worms and the bees. I love nature as much as Squeaks loves cheese. Yes, I love nature. I love the dirt and the rocks and the grass and the trees. Love the birds and the squirrels and the worms and the bees. I love nature as much as Squeaks loves cheese.
Why did the turtle cross the road?
Nature Cat, friend, would you kindly pass the cheese, please?
Here you go, Squeaks!
Thank you, Nature Cat, I appreciate that.
Cheese! Oh, I just love the pond, baby. You know why, baby? Wow, two babies.
Maybe it's because it's so pondy. Right, Hal? Wink, wink.
Granny Bunny, how did you know that I'd say that? Am I that predictable?
It is so sweet to see our friends here. Oh, hey, there's Fern the Salamander.
And Warren the Bullfrog.
And Baby Duckling.
Huh, you know who we haven't seen today? Our pal Phoebe the Turtle.
I wonder where she is.
Oh! It's Phoebe. Phoebe! Phoebe! You cannot cross the road in the middle of traffic.
You certainly cannot.
Oh, but I really have to get across the road right now.
Granny says I can never cross the road without her. Right, Granny?
Oh, you got that right, sweetie.
Phoebe, why does a turtle have to cross the road anyway?
Oh, I got this joke. A turtle has to cross the road because it has something to do with that chicken who always has to cross the road. And I don't know why. I don't even know why it's funny. I really don't.
Every year around this time, I leave the pond and go find a sunny spot by the woods to lay my eggs.
Huh. Well, couldn't you lay your eggs in the water like a frog?
Or in a nest like a bird?
Well, a lot of us turtles that live around the pond like to lay our eggs over there by the woods. And it was always no problem until they built this new road in the way! Sorry about that.
Too bad they didn't think about the animals that have to cross it before they built it.
It's too late now, and I really have to get across, so see you around, I guess.
Stop! You can't cross the road. It's too dangerous.
Yeah, you must listen to Granny Bunny.
Oh, but I really need to lay my eggs now. Sorry.
Fear not, Phoebe. Nature Cat is here to save the day. But the question is how. How shall I save the day? Climb aboard, Phoebe. The Nature Cat Turtle Transport is open for business. Hang on tight, Tally. Ho!
It's really high. That was excellent.
Yeah!
Oh, thank you, Nature Cat. I'll be laying my eggs now.
I bid you adieu, Phoebe. And happy egg-laying!
By the way, I should be through in about an hour or two, so I will be needing a lift back to the pond. Not to be needy. Sorry.
No problem.
Hello, Phoebe.
Sylvia, hi. How many eggs did you lay?
7.
Congrats! Hope to lay about 5 myself. Don't know.
Safety first, Sylvia. Climb aboard the Nature Cat Turtle Transport. Hold on. Tally-ho!
Thanks for the ride.
So, shall we finish our picnic?
Oh, not so fast, Nature Cat. Look!
I got this. Climb aboard.
I heard you're the one giving turtles a lift across the road. Yeah, I'm gonna need one pretty soon.
I am, but the Nature Cat Turtle Transport is officially grounded.
Yeah, looks like I'll just have to walk it.
You may not cross this road. It is much too busy.
What she said.
Nature Cat, the future of these turtles is at stake, don't you see? One of them can grow up to be a scientist. Please.
Hey, maybe there's another place to cross the road.
No way, man. This is a one-way street to Nowheresville. It just goes and goes.
Guys, we gotta think of something.
I'm thinking a little more information would be helpful.
Oh-ho-ho! You know what it's time for, sweetie?
A little scientific investigation!
Car. Truck. Another car. The bike. A car. A motorcycle. A truck. A little car.
We turtles don't always cross in the same place. Sometimes we cross here, or here, or even here.
Well, we turtles have rights too, you know. I'm sorry for yelling.
Yeah, we were here first.
Hold on to your shells. We'll find a way to make a safe turtle crossing. Right, Daisy?
You got it. And check this out. Some roads like these have bridges for animals so they can walk right over the road.
Yeah, it's a bridge.
Oh, Hal, building a bridge might be too difficult.
Okay, Granny Bunny, love you forever.
In that case, there's the tunnel option. Ba-bam!
The tunnel option?
Right you are, gang. There is always the turtle tunnel option.
Hooray!
So you already said you want to build a turtle tunnel? Well, many successful tunnel crossings have been built to allow turtles and other small animals to cross busy roadways safely. First thing is to pick a spot that is convenient for the turtles. Next, simply dig a tunnel under the road. And finally, just insert a tube to keep the tunnel from collapsing. And there you have it, a turtle tunnel.
A tunnel!
Yes, yes, we can do this. We can dig a turtle tunnel.
So most of us cross right around here.
Then it is here we shall dig, eh, what?
Hold up. While we're building the tunnel, we're gonna need someone else to look after the turtles and make sure they don't cross the road.
It's gotta be someone responsible and caring and nice.
And someone who just might be related to you, who might just be so granny and so bunny and all at the same time. Oh, but who can it be?
Granny Bunny!
I'll do it. Ba-bam!
Yes! Ugh, I wish I thought of that. Ugh, I love you, Granny Bunny, forever.
All set, Granny Bunny?
Oh, yes. All set, Daisy dear.
Okay, Hal, all you.
Can you dig it?
Hey, you! Stop!
Thank you.
goodbye, turtle friends, while we properly open the tunnel. Today is a momentous day, a day of great celebration, a day that ushers in an era of safety first. I hereby declare the turtle tunnel officially open!
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
Hello, I'm Hal. Welcome to Turtle Tunnel.
Step lively, ladies. Oh, good luck on the other side.
Hello, I'm Hal again. Welcome to Turtle Tunnel again.
Yes, you got it. It's working. That's really working.
Uh-oh, we have a stray.
Hey, you! Stop! You can't cross there, honey.
No, oh, and another turtle still trying to cross the road down there.
Oh, hey, turtle! You can't cross there either, dearie.
Why aren't the turtles using the tunnel?
Ugh, I don't get it. We dug a really nice tunnel. You dig? You get it?
Yeah, it's easy to walk through and safe for the turtles. Maybe the problem is where we put the tunnel.
No, man. The location's perfect. Leads right to the woods. You're in, you lay your eggs, you're out. What's the problem?
I've got it! The problem isn't the tunnel. It's getting the turtles to go into the tunnel.
You're right, Nature Cat. Check this out. I think we need a fence to funnel the turtles into the tunnel.
Funnel the turtles into the tunnel. Yes, yes, that's it.
Once we put up a fence, the turtles have to go into the tunnel. Let's go.
Yes, yes. Onward and fenceward.
To Turtle Tunnel.
Oh, and hey, other animals can use the tunnel as well. Go ahead, little guy.
How long before the little hatchlings hatch?
2 months.
Could be 4. We don't know.
Well, whenever they hatch, they can use the tunnel to make it home safe and sound.
Speaking of home, I think it's time.
You are correct, Squeaks. Our work here is done.
Oh, goodbye, Nature Cat, and thank you for your help. Sorry for the long day.
Glad to be of service, little turtles. Onward and homeward.